Home sweet home, Sherry. And I was wondering why it's so empty in here.
There may be a small chance that some of our property could be found among local traders' wares. It is worth a look, wouldn't you say? Mycroft's umbrella, the only outgoing thing in his wardrobe. Hey, this is the luggage we brought from London, isn't it? Something did happen that day, but no one can tell us the details. How can that be?
Agreed. It's rather suspicious.
I remember how angry Mycroft was about these marks. He called it a frivolous, childish endeavor. Another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it. Another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it. Another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it.
I heard footsteps upstairs a second ago. Wait,
do we have an attic here?
another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it. One of the first things I saw when entering this house as a child. It's like deja vu.
Another memory incoming, Sherry.
Strange. I struggle to recall anything about the day we moved in. The only detail I'm sure of is that it was raining early that morning. There was always a hat on our stand, but I'm sure it did not belong to Mycroft. Our mother brought a slew of belongings with her. She refused to leave a single thing in London. Mycroft had to spend the whole day dealing with it. This trip was a challenge for our mother. I tried to help her.
Do you feel it? Is it the air shimmering, or is it my imagination?
Your neighbors will be told that Mrs. Holmes is suffering from tuberculosis. It is common to move closer to the sea in such cases.
Thank you, Dr. Richter. No, Sherlock, step away from her. Upstairs, go to your room.
Lean on me, Mother. Take your time.
Actually, I never heard her coughing. I remember now.
Oh, I feel dizzy. It's stuffy in here, isn't it?
John, are you all right?
I'll be okay in a minute. How about we find our room in the meantime?
It's like traveling 10 years into the past with a single step. Oddly satisfying. Need to repeat this one day, but with bullets.
Coal dust from Miner's End, sandy dirt from the old city. We scoured the island top to bottom for these soil samples.
First chemical laboratory I ever made. I almost miss its elegant simplicity.
An artifact from Palau carved out of bone and claimed to be 300 years old. My mother proved it was a fake. I cannot believe all my toys are still here. So many pleasant evenings were spent here with the Encyclopedia Americana. The only fiction book on my table. I can still hear my mother reading it to me. Look at this, John. Remember how desperately I wanted to learn the violin? I never had a proper opportunity.
Such a shame. I always hated the rule about being silent in this place.
A magnificent tool made for a spurious purpose, staring into the sky. I've definitely found a better use for it.
You mean for spying on people? Oh, it reminds me of our neighbour. He had the same balloon in his yard, only bigger. Do you remember?
Yes. We visited him several times while living here. Oh, these must be the notes of my earliest observations. We wanted to locate a particular dog we'd spotted, and we met it, didn't we? I'll never forget how challenging it was to obtain this simple sketch.
Coal dust from Miner's End, sandy dirt from the old city. We scoured the island top to bottom for these soil samples.
First chemical laboratory I ever made. I almost miss its elegant simplicity.
This time I was first to pick beds. This one's mine now.
A magnificent tool made for a spurious purpose, staring into the sky. I've definitely found a better use for it.
Wasn't that neighbor missing a finger?
That does sound vaguely familiar. Wasn't his name, Theodore? Theodore Gildon, perhaps?
It's the perfect time to investigate.
Thank you. That wretch Goliath would murder us all. Mark my words.
Destruction and trampled ground. Oof, a contortionist you were not. Disjointed vertebrae. Difficult to say if it was a way to start or finish him off. A belt from a dressing gown. Curious. A kneecap reduced to splinters. Missing pinky, middle-aged. It's none other than Theodore Gilded.
Oh boy, Sherlock. Another death means another question.
And we shall answer the question. It's far too interesting to give it up to the police. Didn't we get to fly in it as children? I doubt it could hold my weight today.
This is quite comfy.
A royal suite for a favourite pet.
Plenty of food to satisfy even the most fastidious. Poke the elephant with this. Really? People are hopeless.
A strong pull broke this leash. A pool of blood and saliva, possibly as a result of impact.
Sherlock, take a picture of the footprint. It's valuable evidence.
This photograph can help us find the old article about the elephants. The thing. It was hard to believe as a child.
True. We may need it in our investigation.
Thank you.
Do you know anything about this?
I can't help you with that, sir.
Stop the presses. Who is Cordona's handsome stranger? Or nosebagger spurns local life? Wait, no. Foppish foreigner hides dark past. Oh, you've made quite the impression already, Mr. Holmes. You care to tell your side of the story?
I'm quite certain I have no idea as to what you refer, and I am further certain I have no interest in indulging your gossip.
Gossip? The truth will come out, but will only be heard if told well. Scandal, daring do, romance. These are the tools of every good journalist. Nothing travels faster or lasts longer than a great story. Young man, your tale will be told with or without you. My readers demand it.
You already knew my name and seem aware of my doings here in Cordona. I presume this newspaper is your little endeavor?
Yasmin Sertel, editor-in-chief of the Cordona Chronicle. Advocate of the free press, voice of the people, scourge of the silk stocking.
Charmed, I'm sure. As an advocate of the free press, I trust you'll permit me to consult your archives. There are gaps in my knowledge of Cordona.
Oh, so my work does have merit. Well, I think we can strike a bargain. I shall provide you access, and you let me keep writing about your exploits.
So be it.
Brooding bachelor builds bridges. Now that's character development.
I guess I owe you my gratitude.
What can I say? I've always enjoyed working with the Holmes. They whisper such interesting things. closely, Mr. Holmes.
Guests of Cordona, the treasures await you. Collect them all and return for more. Guests of Cordona, the treasures await you. A contest for the guests of Cordona. Find hidden treasure.
Are you lost, sir?
Not at all. I'm right where I need to be. I'm Sherlock Holmes, by the way.
Ursula Oney, the chief archivist. How can I help you exactly?
I need to take a look at the history of Cordona and its islanders to retrieve some, hopefully, useful information.
Your brother Mycroft told me that you were direct, and now that we've met, I can see that is true.
Someone in our family has to balance the evasive nature of my brother. Well, may I use the city archives?
You may, of course. But in return, perhaps dinner?
That's a high price to pay for looking at your archives.
I was teasing you. Pay no attention to me.
Thank you.
be familiar to you.
A contest for the guests of Cordon. Find hidden treasure.
There was a stage here, a tribute. The governor gave his speech there. He was lying through his teeth and nobody noticed, or didn't want to, but I noticed. I was extremely irritated by his lies. I shouted my opinions very loudly for everyone to hear.
The crowd went wild.
Croft was angry but calm. He led me away from the stage. He told me that I should keep my mouth shut, that silence is golden. I couldn't stand for that.
Behold, Sherlock Holmes's famous adherence to justice was born here.
hog heaven. A coal gas tank. Enough to pump up an airship. A sailor's knife, useful for cutting wet and thick ropes. A sailor's knife, useful for cutting wet and thick ropes. It's seen a lot of use. The blade is worn from grinding. Fresh signs of impact. A rough landing led to an altercation with this shed.
You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate.
Ha!
You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate. 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 You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate.
In a fit of rage, the elephant broke the chain and threw its victim on the ground with a fierce power. Escaping the scene, it pulled the body with it, but dropped it at the gate. At least some of this was witnessed by a third party who was hurled against the shed. The elephant can't have gone too far. I can still track it.
I suppose you find it. Then what? Push it all the way back to the manor?
Hog heaven. Destruction and trampled ground. Destruction and trampled ground. May I ask you something?
That's a question I can answer.
Thank you.
elephant barged into this cart of olive oil.
What if we're lucky and he slipped and fell somewhere along the way? Okay, hear me out. If an elephant falls in the forest and there's no one around to...
John, no.
Oh, you're such a killjoy.
Strange. It was hung with care. The game has escaped us for now. We'll find a solution to the elephant problem later.
You? Who are you?
My name is Sherlock Holmes. Theodore Gildon was...
Did he kill him? Did he kill the elephant?
It's not in the yard anymore. It escaped into the forest.
You can't let it go. What if it returns?
I highly doubt that, Miss...
Imogen Gildon. Please, I beg of you, find that dreadful beast that killed my father.
I suppose we do need to learn what happened. Can you tell me what happened? From the very start.
I was here, so I didn't see how it began. My father visits the enclosure every morning to wake up Goliath. Today, I heard the elephant scream. I've never heard such a horrifying sound. My heart stopped. I knew something was wrong. I looked through my window and saw how it lifted my father up by his neck. I rushed downstairs. I saw it dragging my father as if he were a doll. I threw stones at it. It dropped my father's body and charged outside, screaming. Its roar was almost human. I was frightened, so I ran inside and hid here.
That is a terrifying experience, Miss Gildon. I'm sorry you had to go through it.
Thank you. Goliath must be caught, Mr. Holmes.
Well, thank you for the information, Miss Gildon. I did have some questions for your father. Perhaps you might help me with them?
I wasn't privy to much of my father's life. And it's very hard to think of anything at all with Goliath still loose. Please, Mr. Holmes.
Very well. Do you mind if I ask you more questions if I find anything that might help?
Anything to catch that monster!
Miss Gildon, I was on this island 10 years ago, and your father knew my mother. I believe I even had the opportunity to ride that balloon outside, but I do not recall seeing you.
I lived at my late mother's in Sheffield at the time. I'm in no spirit to reminisce right now. The elephant is out there.
You've never heard the name Violet Holmes before? Perhaps your father...
Please, Mr. Holmes, with that beast roaming free, I can't think of anything.
Very well. I have to leave you for now. She packed as much as she could carry. False idols, oh, sounds utterly dreary. Oh, the same dull poses on all romantic photographs. So idyllic. Enjoy your happily ever after before it stales.
Hey, Sherry, we need to talk.
You found false idols. We need to find the remaining two.
What does bazooka even mean? Would this paper be good for anything but blowing one's nose on?
They're not rubbish, Sherry. There's something more. I'm serious.
Very well. I doubt it'll be worth it, but I will find them for you, John.
You'll thank me later. They're some of the most imaginative books I've ever read.
What did you say?
Speaking aloud helps me think. A commendable effort to barricade the windows. Thank you. I found this. Who's this young lad next to you, your faithful knight?
Paul. He's my pirate. He's not really a pirate. I just call him that. It probably sounds very silly.
Your secret is safe in my hands. Does Paul work somewhere? What is his surname?
His name is Paul Perks. He and his yacht Whirlpool are the champions of the Salacia Yacht Club. He sails there. I'll show you where it is on the map, if you need to meet him.
A yachting champion? Huh. Well, that will be a first. I prefer dry land. And so does my suit. How can you read something like this? It's hard to swallow, and that's not due to the hard cover.
You're hardly serious. Any library without Nabe and Laura is incomplete. If you can read, then these books are an absolute must. Love and adventure. They're about life.
Oh, I wasn't aware that exploding pyramids were a part of daily life on Cordona.
You haven't seen life, so you might try reading about it at least.
These bags of yours, it looks as if you've packed your entire room. Were you planning on going somewhere?
My partner and I, we wanted a change, a fresh start abroad. But now I have to stay here. Here, an orphan.
I have to leave you for now. Nicest spot in the room. Mr. Gildan spent hours of his life right here.
Staring at an elephant's backside. What a wonderful life.
Relatively functional choice to replace the finger. Oh, the pungent stench of an animal.
Did Theodore seek some pink elephants with this?
I think Miss Gildan has barely matured. I think they were closer than you and me, John.
I'm hurt.
What's so special about this place? Another elephant? A partnership annulled with a single stroke of a pen. A catchy title. I should take a photograph of the plans. I don't want to carry them around. His second child? An apparent son and heir, I'd say. Mother. It's nice to see her young and smiling. From before Mycroft was born, our family loves to prod at the past.
Holmes's desire to rake up the past is hereditary.
Quite the spectrum. From the history of the Roman Empire to conspiracy theories of the French Revolution. This young lady has a childish interest for her age. I can always recognize the spirit of a true artist. Thank you. Champion's Whirlpool. Pool's bread and butter. Foghorn to navigate and warn others at sea.
It should have a warning to cover your ears. We can become pirates and show them what should be stored in here.
Bloodied bandages. Is someone being hurt?
Where would a champion hide a key?
I hope Paul is more skilled at yachting than he is at hiding keys. Bloodied bandages. To earn big, you have to spend big. Mr. Gildan wasn't afraid to get his hands dirty.
old betting slips, Paul always bets on Whirlpool, one victory after another. An interesting place for a message to a champion. Additional earnings to sweeten the victory. An expensive set of tools for woodwork. An amateur wouldn't know how to use these. Box full of darts. Each has a needle and can be loaded with drugs. Shipbuilding, shipwright's tricks, sail weaving. Bandages. Are you aware that Paul smuggles drugs for a dangerous gang?
Mr. Holmes, I've already told you. I call him a pirate in play. He's not an actual pirate. He's a champion and a brave gentleman, not a thug.
Let us agree to disagree on that. But don't be surprised if one of his clients knocks on your door.
Hey,
Have you seen what your father sent to Paul?
This is despicable. My father was never a gentleman, but this crosses the line. I knew that father wasn't fond of Paul, but this... this is just awful. If only he could have seen how good Paul he is to me. I don't have any thoughts on this. I don't have any thoughts on this.
A. Swift, is this name familiar to you? Your father had it removed from this plan.
Oh, that's Arthur Swift. I've seen him a couple of times here. He works with my father in the old city, digging up something ancient.
He is an archaeologist?
That's the word, yes. But to be truthful, I really don't think Mr. Swift is fit to be one. I've just learnt a lot about archaeology from my favourite book series. Oh, they are page turners.
Inspirational, I'm sure, but would you happen to know where this Mr. Swift might be found?
I don't, but perhaps you can find out somewhere. My father's work with him is all official. Lots of boring legal papers with signatures and stuff.
And, which part of the elephant is in here? It's quite pungent.
Oh, that. It's elephant sweat. Father believed that it might replace traditional amber grease.
Well, that's true entrepreneur spirit. I have to leave you for now.
Who's here? What nice weather.
Do you know anything about this?
Excuse me? What? I'm not sure I know.
Ooh.
Market Square, beating heart of the old city.
I wonder if they still sell that heavenly Turkish delight around the corner.
Nice of
Oriental rugs at a good price.